So you, this person, does it exist? You saw that when you were like 15. Did that have an impact on you? And, and explain what that is.
Yeah, so thispersondoesnotexist.com is it's a website that outputs images of people that don't exist. And this is powered by GAN, right, which is an AI that generates things based on the data it's trained on. And, you know, a couple of my friends, they were like, you have to check out this website, you know? And, you know, we kept on looking at the images that it generated, and we were amazed at, like, these people do not exist, right? And, you know, the light bulb went off in me. I was like, well, if you can create people that don't exist, what else can you generate that also doesn't exist, you know? And so AI, since seeing that, I've been interested in how AI can generate assets or content and stuff.
Yep. So there's virtual reality. You put a toaster on your head. You get immersed in the digital world. It's like the Matrix. But when Iron Man, who's an MIT grad, Tony Stark, Stark is the middle name of Draper. That's where Stanley came up with it, Charles Draper Stark, or Stark Draper. When Iron Man goes around, he gets digital information on the physical world. And some people say we're connected to our phones looking down too much, but AR, digital information on the physical world, once we get the latency issue down and 5G and content, 6G or whatever, all the digital information on the physical world will be very interesting. So when you think of AI and AR, what are you excited about? What was your big aha?
Yeah, so
what I'm... be dramatic here, because this is...
What I'm really excited about with the intersection of AR and AI is that you can generate anything that you can imagine. I think that AI, specifically generative AI, will be the creative engine for AR, right? And this has applications in business, right? If you're working at a construction site, you can, you know, say generate this 2x4 piece so we could see how it looks here. Or if you're in research, you could be like, generate this protein so that we could see it in its 3D form. But what I'm really interested in is generative AI for using, for generating content for AR.
So generative AI, I never heard those two words put together. Did that pop, and maybe people are using it, but did that pop into your head?
Yeah, so it popped into my head, and I kept on thinking of like this term. I don't know if it's an actual term that people are using much.
Scott Kirshner, when you need him, he could write about this. Keep going.
Generative reality, right? It's basically using generative deep learning to create things to put in your reality, whether that's 3D models or 2D assets, stickers. You're basically employing an AI to generate things to put in the world around you.
So is Minecraft and Roblox, are they using AI to create this at this point?
Yeah, so, you know, Minecraft, I grew up on Minecraft, right?
You were eight when it came out.
I was eight when it came out, and I grew up right outside Chicago. And one thing I loved doing was going downtown. I loved seeing the 3D public monuments, the artwork, like the Bean, the Picasso, and I loved looking at the skyscrapers, like the Sears Tower. And I always wanted to build my own things or make additions on top of those things. And when Minecraft came out and one of my friends showed it to me, you know, I was amazed, you know. I could basically create my own world in 3D in anything using Minecraft.
All right, so say something surprising and say something that you're worried about this new tool. So basically, you think AR is a big thing, but now that we can use AI to create the digital world, that's a game changer, right? What's surprising and what's concerning about these superpowers?
Yeah, so every person in this room and everyone listening and everyone on Earth has within them a desire to create something in 3D. And it's more pronounced in people that are my age and younger, or your children or your relatives or something, because they've grown up with tools like Minecraft and Roblox. They can create in 3D. Right, and what generative AI will do is it will allow you to create in 3D, and what AR will do is it will allow you to put your generations in the real world. And one of the main concerns is, you know, there's a lot of controversy around AI-generated content and whether or not it's ethical, whether or not it can be copyrighted, whether or not it's really art, you know? And I don't think we should really look at AI as a replacement of art, right? As generated content as a replacement of human-created content, but rather I think we should look at AI as a tool, right? Something that's not replacing the human mind or the human spirit, but rather amplifying the human heart.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, our youngest speaker, Alex.
Thank you.